As a person living with type 1 diabetes and a person using a continuous glucose monitor, which I'm sure you're familiar with as an endocrinologist,
yes.
I have the ability to see what's happening after every single meal. So I can monitor how much insulin do I need to manage my blood glucose and what is my blood glucose profile. So I can share from that personal experience that what I've seen is a maximization of my insulin sensitivity. And I really think it's important that we go back and understand what is insulin resistance and why is that important for people living with all forms of diabetes. So that research goes all the way back to the 1920s. So insulin resistance, what that is when you consume a diet of excess dietary fat. Okay, you have too much fat. This fat gets stored in cells which are not designed to store fat, your muscle and liver cells. Now, a simple way to understand this, which I really want the audience to get, is if you think of your kitchen sink, okay? The water comes out of the faucet, it goes through the drain, no problem, all right? That's an insulin-sensitive sink, okay? So if you ate a banana, you're in an insulin-sensitive state, your body's able to take that glucose out of your bloodstream and put it into your cells. That's insulin-sensitive person. Now, if you start to clog the drain by consuming high-fat meals, the water will accumulate in the sink, eventually it'll spill over the edge, and now you have high blood glucose readings. That's what happens when people eat a banana living with diabetes, they test their blood glucose, and it's high. It's because they're living with insulin resistance. So as you eat a high-fat diet, you are continuing to clog the drain. It's getting more and more clogged, and you are living with insulin resistance at that point.
You still use or take insulin.
We're not claiming.
And I think that is providing some clarification here, because you're not curing your type 1 diabetes and automatically stopping your insulin. You're still using what we call medicine exogenous insulin. So I just want to clarify for people watching, because there's a huge misconception that people are really confused between type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes. Yeah.
The important point is that we're using a physiological normal amount of insulin while consuming more than 7 times the amount of carbohydrate that typical low-carb eaters eat. So in our clients, we see in hundreds of people living with type 1 diabetes in our cells, dramatic improvement in insulin sensitivity. So we will consume more than 700 grams of carbohydrate per day and use 27 units of total insulin.
Your clients eat things like avocados or nuts, which are plant-based? We know that they are higher in healthy, heart-healthy fats. Where do those types of foods fit in your paradigm?
Absolutely. So foods like avocados, nuts, seeds, coconuts, olives, these are all plant-based fat-rich foods, which fall into the yellow light category. So we're not by any stretch of imagination saying don't eat these foods. We recommend people eat these foods because they're very nutrient dense as well, but eating them in small proportions, because a little bit of that goes a long way.
Okay, so let me ask you this. I saw that you have an internet-based program, right?
Correct.
You do some personal coaching through video chats, and then you also have a retreat in Costa Rica.
Correct.
Okay. Do you do any sort of medical assessment prior to those folks coming down?
Absolutely. So we actually encourage all of our patients to work with their doctor and get medical supervision during this entire process, because Robby and I are not MDs. We don't have the ability to change people's prescriptions. And so we encourage not only all of our patients with type 1 and type 2 to work with their doctor, but to actually partner with their doctor for the long term. And the reason for that is because a whole food plant-based diet is so powerful at reducing your need for oral medication and insulin that if you were to try and make these changes by yourself, you could make an error and actually cause a significant medical emergency.
Sure. So do you require any sort of medical sign-off before they come down?
To Costa Rica?
Yes.
Absolutely.